Welcome to Digital Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain time division multiplexing. So this session is all about time division multiplexing, where in multiplexing, all we do is we send multiple signal over a single channel. So many signals, that is what we are transferring over a single channel, that is what multiplexing. But here, when we explain time division multiplexing, then in time division multiplexing, the basic parameter over which we do multiplexing, that will be purely based on time. So here everything that is what we multiplex with respect to time, that's why it is what time division multiplexing. Now see, I have already explained sampling theorem, and in which one of the popular method of sampling that I have already explained, that is what flat top sampling, that even referred as pulse amplitude modulation. So when you send signal by using PAM, pulse amplitude modulation, you will be finding sampled signal is off for the most of the time period. So during off time period, channel can be used to send another sample of other signal, and that is what the basic concept that we will be going to utilize. So the concept of interleaving samples from several signal into single waveform is called as time division multiplexing. So let us try to understand that step by step. So for example, if I say I am sending one signal like this, and in that signal when I utilized pulse amplitude modulation, then I will be sending pulses like this. So this is what I am sending in pulse amplitude modulation. Now you will be observing, for this time period only, if I say this width of pulse, that is tau, then for this time period only I am sending signal, and for this space there is nothing, which is what we are sending, so this space is blank. So that is what we will be utilizing in TDM. So how we will be utilizing that, let us try to understand that. For example, if you have two signals, so this is one signal and I have second signal, that is like this. Now for example, if I want to use time division multiplexing by using pulse amplitude modulation, then for example, if I send one pulse during this interval, then for next pulse of same signal, if I say that is over here, and next pulse that is over here, then in time division multiplexing, all we do is we'll be sending pulse with this blank space. So we can choose pulse over here for second signal, we can choose pulse over here for this second signal. Likewise, it is possible, like there could be multiple signal where we can merge or interleave samples of different signals in a single waveform. So that is what the case which we do in time division multiplexing using pulse amplitude modulation. So I think basic concept is clear to all, where what we do is in pulse amplitude modulation, we send pulses with sampling rate. So for off time period, we can utilize that time period to send sample of other signal. Like as we do it over here, we have seen for two signals, if I send signal with pulse over here and over here, then in between this space, we can utilize this space with respect to time for other signals pulses, and that is what we do it in time division multiplexing using pulse amplitude modulation. So let us try to understand that by block diagram, so it will be more clear. So here we have multiple signals x1, x2, x3 up to xn, and that is what we pass it through low pass filter. Now here, when you pass this signal through low pass filter, this low pass filter, that is what we are utilizing as anti-aliasing filter. So this low pass filter, this is what we are utilizing as anti-aliasing filter. So for anti-aliasing we are using this, so that bandwidth of signal is not getting merged with respect to consecutive signals. Now then after we are using switches at transmitter side and at receiver side. At transmitter side this switch is called as commutator, and at receiver side this switch is called as decommutator. Now what is the idea? Let us try to understand that. Now see, all we do is here this commutator that is connected to signal 1 to send sample of signal 1, then this commutator switch is getting rotated. So next time when it comes over here will be sending sample of signal 2, and when it rotates to signal n will be sending nth signals sample over here, and that is what we give it to pulse amplitude modulator, and then we send it through a channel. So this is what transmitter block diagram, where in transmitter block diagram these many components are there. Signals are given to low pass filter, then it is given to commutator, and then it is given to pulse amplitude modulator, where this commutator that is what rotating and taking samples of different signals, and then it is been sent to channel. So let us try to understand that what happens here. If I say I have one sample over here of first channel, so when I send it through this signal over here, if commutator is connected over here, this sample that will come over here. Then when it rotates over here and when second sample is there with second signal, so that second sample, if I say it is this, then next time that sample will be this, and when it revolves to n sample you'll be finding that n sample that will come over here, and this is what keeps on repeating. Now see, one thing that we need to understand, it is not compulsory that we should send only one sample. We can send multiple samples even of single channel, single signals. So it could be two samples that we can take it from X1. It could be more than two samples that we can take it from any signal. But idea is we should be sending signal with samples, and that is what we are merging with respect to time by using this commutator. So when this commutator switch is connected to signal 1, samples of signal 1 that will come over here, and when it rotates and it is connected to signal 2, signal 2 sample will come over here. Likewise this commutator switch will rotate with some speed, and based on that you'll be finding samples which is coming over here, and that is been given to pulse amplitude modulator, and then there it is passing through channel, and then again it will come back to pulse amplitude demodulator. Now when it comes to pulse amplitude demodulator, again same sample sequence that you will be having, like this is from first sample, first signal, second sample that is from second signal, and this is what nth sample, this is what nth sample from nth signal. Now here there is a decommutator. Now see what happens when this decommutator, that is again a switch which is synchronous to commutator. So this commutator switch that is having idea like which sample that is coming from which signal. Like see, this sample that is coming from X1, second sample by this orange color that is coming from X2, and n sample that is by red color which is coming from Xn. So that idea that is there with commutator as well as decommutator. So both are synchronous to each other. So what happens is here this switch that will rotate with respect to time. And what it does is it gives X1 sample to X1, second sample to X2, and n sample to xn. And this is what keeps on repeating. So you'll be finding, if sequence of samples are there, then you'll be finding multiple samples with respect to time that is coming over here. Likewise, multiple samples for x2 that will come over here, and multiple samples for xn that will come over here. And then we just pass it through low pass filter for smoothening, and you will be extracting signal at x1, x2 up to xn. So this is what the basic idea that we have to have time division multiplexing. So here, by using pulse amplitude modulation, we do time division multiplexing, where the basic idea is, when you do pulse amplitude modulation, you just pass those samples which is there with signal when time is available. Like, see, as I have explained, for this first signal, if you send samples over here, then this space is blank, which is what with respect to time. So during that time period, we can use that space for other signal sample, and you can merge it. So that is what we do it by using this commutator, where commutator is a switch which is connected to signal 1 when sample of signal 1 is on, and that will move on to sample signal 2 when sample of signal 2 is on, and that is what keeps on rotating. So it is merging all those samples which is coming from multiple signals, and that is what we give it to pulse amplitude modulator. And this is what the basic idea of time division multiplexing. At receiver side, this commutator and decommutator both are synchronized, so both have idea about which sample that is coming from which signal. So when sample is coming from first signal, this commutator and decommutator switch both are connected to signal 1, and at the end of both there is low pass filter. At receiver side, low pass filter is been utilized for smoothing operation, and at transmitter side, low pass filter that is been utilized for anti-aliasing. So here, by this basic diagram, one can understand this is what time division multiplexing, where this is one frame. What is one frame? It is a time required to rotate commutator for one revolution. Like, see, this is what commutator that is getting revolved, and that is what that is getting switch in between multiple signals. So once it completes one complete revolution, it will be sending one frame. So when it is connected to signal x1, it is sending sample of signal x1. When it is connected to signal x2, it is sending sample of signal x2. When it is connected to x3, it is sending sample of x3. So likewise, up to xn, it is sending sample of signal xn. So once it completes one revolution, that is what one frame. And that is what keeps on repeating. Next time, this will be the frame which it will be sending, which is what interleaving of samples of multiple signals. So this is second frame. Now see, what will be the minimum bandwidth which we need to send by using TDM PAM. So if I say signal x1 that is having bandwidth w1, signal x2 that is having bandwidth w2, signal x3 that is having bandwidth w3, then up to signal xn that is having bandwidth wn, then minimum bandwidth, that will be algebraic sum of all. So that will be w1 plus w2 plus w3 plus up to wn. So that will be I varies from 1 to n wi. So this is what minimum bandwidth which is required to send signal by using TDM PAM. So this is what TDM PAM minimum bandwidth requirement. So that is how we do time division multiplexing. I hope that this session is clear to all, and by this I think one can learn how to solve examples based on time division multiplexing. So that is what I'll be going to solve it in next session. So stay tuned with this channel. You will be finding examples based on time division multiplexing, which will be helpful to you to understand how TDM has been getting done and how we can control bandwidth as well as data rate by using time division multiplexing. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give your valuable suggestions